Are you tired of math class and need something to do? Here are an assortment of 10 different games that you can play in your calculator. We'll be covering a variety of games from Connect 4 to chess to slider puzzle. You'll never feel bored in math class again. The first game we have today is Connect 4, a very easy and simple game to set up and play. Press the fraction sign and type 7 zeros. Repeat this until you have 6 rows of 7 zeros. Once you have set up the board, go to a space. Press delete and replace with an X for player 1 or divide for player 2. Mancala is a game you may recognize from Club Penguin and is one of the world's oldest games. The main objective is to leave your opponent with no more seeds. To play a Mancala, type fraction and fill the top and bottom rows with 6 threes. Then add a zero to the right and left sides of the fraction. On your turn, select a seed from your side and replace it with a zero. Then spread the seeds one by one clockwise. Player 1 will take the top side, while player 2 will take the bottom side. In 6 Men's Morris, the goal is to remove your opponent's pieces by getting your men to line up in threes. You start with an empty board and add pieces one at a time to the board. After 6 turns, you start the next phase of the game where you move pieces along the lines or to an adjacent zero space. If 3 men form a horizontal or vertical line in either phase, you get to remove an opponent's piece. The goal of the game is to get rid of all your opponent's pieces. Goblet is tic-tac-toe with a twist. You can place bigger pieces over smaller pieces to overwrite a space. The game is played on a 4x4 board with the objective being to get 4 pieces in a row. Player 1 uses odd numbers 1 through 7, while player 2 uses even numbers 2 through 8. The larger the number, the larger the piece. While larger pieces are great for overwriting an opponent's move, you have a limited supply of each piece, so place wisely. The sides of the board keep track of how many of each piece you have left. Checkers is played on an 8x8 board with 1 being blank, 2 being the player on the left, and 3 being the player on the right. 4 and 5 stand for kinged pieces. To move, retype the piece numbers on the rows where your piece is from and where it is going to. Before we get into the next 2 games, make sure frequency is turned on so you get an extra column. Battleship is a classic game that you can now play on your calculator. To start, go into Statistic 2 mode. Fill rows 1 through 6 with 1s. This will be used by player 1. Fill rows 7 through 10 with a 0. And fill rows 11 through 16 with 1s. This will be used by player 2. The first 9 columns on the left will be used for defense. 1s are the C. Ships are marked with 2s, and hit ships are marked with 3s. The last 9 columns on the right are for offense. Use 1s as a C, 4 for a miss, and 5 for a hit. On your turn, call out the coordinates of where you want to attack, and scroll to rows 7 through 10 so your opponent won't see your board. Then your opponent will pick up the calculator and scroll to their side to check if it was a hit or miss. Chess is played by going into Statistic 2. This game uses 2 digits to represent pieces. so it might be helpful to write down what each piece means before playing. The game is played from left to right and uses the same movement process as checkers. Retype the row you are from and the row you are moving to. Player 1 uses numbers 1 through 5, and Player 2 uses letters A through E. 0 is used as a blank space. The board is set up with 3 fractions side by side. Once you have made the fractions, fill the board like this. The goal of backgammon is to get rid of all your pieces. At the start of your turn, you roll 2 dice. You move a piece by the number shown on the first die. Then you move the same or different piece by the number shown on the second die. When you get to the last 6 spaces, you can get rid of them by rolling a number equal or higher to than the space they are on. There is more rules to the game, but that is the basic idea of it. Slider Puzzle will give your mind a task as you slide pieces around to correct the sequence. If you are playing a 3x3 game, assign numbers 1 through 8 randomly, then put a 0 in the 9th spot. 0 will act as the free space. If you are playing a larger 4x4 game, assign characters 1 through F randomly and put a 0 in the 16th spot. Then start sliding to solve the puzzle. For our last game today, 10 is the calculator version of 2048. Instead of numbers doubling when they merge, they go up by 1 until you reach a value of 10 to win the game. To start, make a 4x4 grid filled with zeros and insert 2 ones in random spots on the board. On each turn, pick a direction for the numbers to slide in. Then alternate between inserting a 1 or a 2 in the center tiles of the board. If all the center tiles are occupied, then go to the sides. Then the corners if those are occupied as well. The goal is to slide the numbers so they merge up to 10. Those are 10 games that you can play on your calculator. With the knowledge of these games, you can conquer boredom in any math class with friends, or on your own. Share these games with your friends so they can enjoy math class as well. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video. If none of those are good enough, there is always the classic game of Race to 100.